If f of x equals 3x squared natural log 4x, we want to find the first, second, and third derivative functions. The first thing we should recognize is that the given function is a product of two functions, since we have 3x squared times natural log 4x. So to find our derivatives, we'll have to apply the product rule of differentiation given here. Where if we want to find the derivative of f times g with respect to x, this will equal f times g prime plus g times f prime, or we can say the derivative is equal to the first function times the derivative of the second function plus the second function times the derivative of the first function. So looking at the given function, we'll let function f be equal to 3x squared, and we'll let function g be equal to natural log 4x. Notice that function g is a composite function, so when finding g prime, we'll have to apply the chain rule. So let's start by writing out the product rule to find the first derivative. We'll have f prime of x is equal to f times g prime plus g times f prime, or the first function, times the derivative of the second function, plus the second function, times the derivative of the first function. Notice how we haven't found any derivatives yet. We wrote out the product rule, so now we'll go back and find the derivative here and here, and then find the product and hopefully simplify. So now we have f prime of x equals 3x squared. Now to find the derivative of natural log 4x, we need to recognize that this is a composite function. So we'll let the inner function equal u. So in this case, u is equal to 4x. So to find the derivative of natural log u with respect to x, this will be equal to 1 over u times u prime. So the derivative would be 1 over 4x times the derivative of 4x, which would be 4, plus natural log 4x times the derivative of 3x squared. So we're going to multiply by the exponent. That would give us 6, subtract 1 from the exponent, so our derivative is 6x. Now let's simplify. Notice this is 4 over 1, so 4 over 4 simplifies to 1.
Then we have 3x squared times 1 over x.
So one of the factors of x will simplify out. This will simplify to 1. This will simplify to x to the first. So this first product is just 3x. So f prime of x is equal to 3x. And then here we'll just have plus 6x natural log 4x. We need to be careful here. We can't add this 3x and the 6x because the 6x is attached to the natural log by multiplication. So this would be our first derivative. And now to find the second derivative, we'll find the derivative of the first derivative, which we'll do on the next slide. So again, to find the second derivative, we'll take the derivative of the first derivative. The derivative of 3x would be 3, plus, but now to find the derivative of 6x times natural log 4x, we have to apply the product rule again. So this time we'll let the first function f equal 6x, and the second function g be equal to natural log 4x. So applying the product rule, again we'll have f times g prime plus g times f prime, where the first function times the derivative of the second function plus the second function times the derivative of the first function. So we have f double prime of x equals 3 plus 6x times the derivative of natural log 4x. Again, this is a composite function, so we'll let the inner function 4x be equal to u. So the derivative of natural log u with respect to x, again, is going to be 1 over u times u prime, or 1 over 4x times the derivative of 4x, or u prime, which is 4, plus natural log 4x times the derivative of 6x, which would just be 6. Now again, let's simplify. So we have 3 plus, again this 4 is over 1. 4 over 4 simplifies to 1. 6x times 1 over x. Now the x's simplify. So we're left with just 6. Then we have plus 6 natural log 4x. Well, we can combine 3 and 6 because those are like terms. So we have f double prime of x equals 9 plus 6 natural log 4x. Again, it might be tempting to try to add the 9 and the 6, but we cannot do this because the 6 is attached to the natural log by multiplication. So now we have our second derivative function. So to find the third derivative, we'll find the derivative of the second derivative, which again we'll do on the next slide. So now to find the third derivative, or triple prime of x, we'll find the derivative of the second derivative. Well, the derivative of 9 is equal to 0. The derivative of 6 natural log 4x is going to be equal to 6 times the derivative of natural log 4x. So again, this is a composite function. The inner function is equal to u. The derivative of natural log u with respect to x is equal to 1 over u times u prime, which would be 1 over 4x times the derivative of 4x, which is 4. So again, this 4 and this 4 simplify to 1. So our third derivative is equal to 6 times 1 over x, or 6 divided by x. And that's going to do it for this example. I hope you found this helpful.